guys. So yes, I am in my bathroom, and I planned on making a vlog today, where I was gonna just be here in the bathroom getting ready while Reagan was jumping in his bouncer, and you know, I was gonna show some scenes of him jumping and talk to him too, but he went to sleep. I ain't complaining. No way am I complaining. I'm very happy that he's asleep. It was his choice. He was like, drink milk, and he was like, I'm done. So, I don't really have a certain subject for this video today. It's very casual, and it's going to, you know, I'm just going to be talking about how things are going with me and baby. And, yeah, I know I don't look that glamorous right now, but so be it. I'm just gonna straighten my hair. I don't have anywhere to go today. There's really no point in wearing makeup. Yeah. So, I'm just waiting for this to heat up. Last week was a very rough week for us. Reagan is now 6 months old. And he had his 6 month appointment, and that requires shots, 4 shots, and then the liquid rotavirus, which he has no problem with that, but the shots, he was like, he got over it pretty fast. He cried, but he was okay. And then he was jumping in the waiting room, but he had the DTaP shot, which for me, when I had it, that killed my arm. And I learned that if you exercise your arm right away, it doesn't hurt as bad. And so that's cool. So maybe him jumping around exercising helped right away. But, okay, when he first had his shots when he was little, very little, they didn't affect him, like 1 month old. It didn't affect him. But when he got older, I can't remember which appointment it was, maybe 4 months or something. That one, he got a fever, slight fever, and he felt miserable. But this one, oh my goodness, look out for 6 months. They say when babies are 6 months old, that they're a lot more sensitive to the shots. So I kind of knew what to expect, but okay, so the next day, he was fine that day. He was a little fussy, but he was okay. But the next day, he was just completely miserable. He was warm all over. Kept checking his temperature, and according to what I read, babies' temperatures can be between 97 and 100 and still be okay. But once they reach past a certain 100 mark, then it's not good. But his temperature is usually between 96 and 97. And it went up to 99. And that was hot for him, because he was really warm for a couple of days. And I did things to cool him down. You know, gave him cool baths, lukewarm baths, and whatnot. But to make matters worse, I discovered he was teething. And this teething was real teething this time. It wasn't that pre-teething stage that he had a couple months ago. This was real. I feel a tooth on your gums coming in, teething. So he has a tooth here he's getting, and one on top. So that made matters completely worse. He was miserable for about 4 days, almost five, but basically 4 days of misery, crying a lot, very whiny, very upset, very confused and not understanding what was going on with him, and just wanting to be held constantly, wanting someone to pulled him while he slept. Instead of being put in bed, he would scream when you put him down. So we just passed him around. And yeah, that was that. So my warning to you as a new mother, and this, if you're watching and you're a new mom and your baby's not quite 6 months yet, look out for that 6 month appointment, because your baby is going to possibly be teething at the same time as the shots, and there's nothing you can do really to avoid it unless you know that, you know, that your baby is going to be teething. I mean, if he shows the signs before his appointment, maybe you want him to go through that a little bit before he gets the shots, but, or her. But the thing is, you really need to get the shots before it's too late, because it's really important. I mean, say what you want about not immunizing your kids, and I know there's a lot of arguments against it, but I'm doing it because it's safer, and I'm not only protecting my child, but I'm protecting other children, because a lot of people did not get their kids vaccinated in Washington State, and whooping cough came back and it killed babies because people aren't getting it back, getting their kids vaccinated, and I don't want that happening to him. So a few days of him feeling miserable and not feeling well is worth it compared to him dying or having something even worse and feeling even worse. Something that's harder to manage, or even maybe not curable. So yeah, that's that. So I'm just warning you guys that you get your baby shots, get all that good stuff done, and and they'll be better for it in the long run. And just be warned that between six months and a year, that's major teething time. And 6 months is at the point where they're going to be like, I don't know what's happening to me. So they're going to be extra whiny and extra confused and upset. And if they got their shots, they're going to be even more miserable. So be prepared to set some time aside to do absolutely nothing but be there for your baby. Because I was somewhat prepared, but not completely prepared to be holding him all the time. Yeah, you know, you have to put him down sometimes, but it was rough. It was really rough. And there was nights where I was sleeping on the couch with him, and I was holding him, and we'd sleep together on the couch. But there was also this couple nights where he would just be bawling in my face, and I'd be bawling because I'm like, I feel so bad for you, you know. I want to take on this pain. I want to feel this for you so you don't have to go through it. And he was just so sad. I'd never seen his face so sad before. It just broke my heart. So just be physically and emotionally prepared for that, if you can. It's not really anything you really can prepare for. Just be aware of it and ready. That you know that it's gonna happen. So now it's like, I'm like, okay, next appointment, I know he's gonna be miserable a few days, so don't make any plans. And it makes me sad to see him like that. But like I said, in the long run, it's gonna be way better for his health and work up immunity to things. And I know this isn't it. I know I have many years down the road of him being sick and stuff like that. So, yeah, that's just part of being a parent, right? Part of being a new mom, or any mom. And I told my mom, because there's 3 girls in our family, I said, I don't know how you did this. I don't know how you went through this 3 times. because I can barely do it with one. It breaks my heart and it's tiring, and I was completely exhausted. And she didn't really remember because it's been a long time. But other people have said it's just something you do, something you get through. If you have to do it again, you do it again. But right now at this point, I'm like, one is enough. With my age, I don't even know if we're gonna have another kid, but if God sees sort of blesses with one, then I pray he gives me the strength to deal with it, because it's a rough thing, it really is. So that's basically what's been going on with us. He is feeling much better now. He is back to his old self. That was it. It wasn't even his self. That's what was heartbreaking too. Just, he was so sad and so confused as to what was going on with him. He wasn't smiling and laughing. Once in a while, you can give him a laugh a little bit. It was like basically laughing through tears. And that was sad too. So, the morning that he woke up smiling, I was like, I wanted to go back to bed. And I came in and he was awake. And I was like, oh, you're awake, no. But he was smiling. And I was like, oh, you know, I was so happy because he was awake and smiling and feeling better. And just seeing that smile looking down at him in his bed, it melted my heart and it made me happy because I knew he was feeling better. He was going to have a better day. So yeah, it's exciting. We've hit a few milestones. Like I said, in his forest walk video, he's eating now. He is eating foods. So far, so good. He's not allergic to anything. Not allergic to rice cereal. Not allergic to oatmeal. Not allergic to fruits or vegetables so far. He's had ham, baby ham. Not allergic to that yet. I mean, I haven't noticed, he just had it last night. He's doing really well. I'm really blessed. So hopefully he will continue to be healthy and not have any problems like that, any allergies. So far what I'm noticing is just that he has the same allergies I do. As far as like sensitivity in his sinuses, and his dad has none. His dad doesn't have allergies. He doesn't understand what it's like to have sensitive sinuses. Lucky him. But we do. So yeah, another milestone we've reached is he sits up now. Reagan, look at the baby in the mirror. Baby! Yeah, so that's him sitting up. It's really cute to see him sitting on his own. And it gives me a little bit more freedom to be able to set him down and not know if he's going to roll into something. I do surround him with pillows so that if he falls back, he's able to the side, but he's not going to hurt himself. But it's just really cute to see him becoming a little person. And exciting. So I'm going to go write some stuff down in my baby book. And hopefully he'll stay asleep for a little while, but I just want to let you guys know what's going on with us. And just remember, new moms, just to be warned about the 6 month shot appointment, that it is not fun when you go home, especially if you get hit with a double whammy like I did with his teething. So, be good.